What is up, beautiful people? It's Celadon here with another video. I'm getting asked a lot about my weird UI layout and the fact that a lot of items are completely missing from the screen, and this guide will give you my best idea about HUD editor settings or heads-up display editor that you should be using while playing Smite. First of all, let's reset the HUD and I will walk you through the problems with the default UI layout and how, in my opinion, you can fix or improve upon them. There are several big issues with the default HUD placement that you can see straight away and a couple more that are hidden. The main problem with the default layout is of course the position of the map. In case you don't know, which is a little bit counterintuitive for a third-person game, the place you should be looking at most of the time while you're playing Smite, like any other MOBA genre game, is your map. This stems from the idea that Smite is MOBA genre, and in old MOBA titles that spawned the genre as a whole, you would usually see your map in the corner of the screen. Problem here is that those MOBAs stem from an RTS-based games that are not as dynamic and where you can have great awareness about what is happening around your character, since you're looking at them from a so-called bird-eye view. You also can look at any point of the map with your camera while controlling the character in the other corner of it as well. All of that is not the case with Smite, since you cannot technically look behind you without pointing your character in that direction, and you are denied awareness about your teammates and other points of interest on the map unless you are standing right next to them. And the only way, which is also the best way to sort of compensate for that, is to look at your map. But since Smite is a third-person action game that is much more dynamic than mentioned games, you also need to look at your character and right in front of you. And every time you switch your attention from map to your god and back, you're wasting your attention span. There are also your health and mana and the cooldowns on your relics and your skills with passive meters from some gods being really important, and the well-being of your teammates and their ultimates availability with how many of the enemies and teammates are alive against each other, and your buffs and debuffs and objective health during sieges. Every single piece of that information is extremely crucial whenever you have any engagement or a team fight, and is checked upon multiple times during every enemy engagement or a team fight while controlling your god and fighting other people at the same time. And they're kind of spread out around the screen in a very aesthetically pleasant but completely uninformative way. They're spread out like this for you to have a broad field of view and for the interface to be aesthetically pleasant, but most of the time during crucial moments exactly, the screen is actually completely bloated by those elements, making you unable to react and respond or even see anything at all. With the default layout, your attention span is actually constantly jumping around different corners of the screen, and this guide is going to help you optimize your screen layout to be more effective during game. We will go through the list of elements one by one, and I will give you my best idea about the usefulness or lack thereof of every element and where you should place it, and the reasoning behind it. The goal we are trying to achieve here is to get rid of the elements that provide no important information or the information of which is duplicated somewhere else, while also stacking up crucial elements around our two main areas of attention. First one being your center of the screen, your point of aim or your god, and the second one will be your map. We will also try to make most of the information available with your peripheral vision during control of those areas. Accolade display is an element that will show you an icon of the accolade that you just achieved, like when you get your pentakill or a godlike status. And this is actually useful for us is during an objective being contested. In tight situations with the objective steal, it is sometimes hard to make out who actually got it. With Fire Giant, for example, you might react to your buff display and a buff belt around your god. But if you are dead, accolade display will come in handy and will give you an icon that your team just took fire. With the Gold Fury, if you weren't paying close attention to your team gold, which you shouldn't during contesting an objective, the only way to tell whether your team actually got it is the accolade. And same goes for Pyromancer. Since the display is right around your top center, it blocks a lot of information. We haven't changed anything yet, I will just place it where I think is best and explain its position later on. Accolade title serves the same purpose as accolade display, but in form of a text. Since icons are more informative and quicker to understand, you want to get rid of it. Best way to get rid of the element is to check the hide HUD element box. Make it as small as possible for convenience of using HUD editor further on, and put it somewhere in the corner like here and forget it exists. Achievement will pop up in the right of the screen and might distract you a little bit. Achievements also don't affect anything in the game and are just a rudimentary part of the game that is long forgotten. You cannot move that element since it's badly implemented, so just hide HUD element and move on. It will still play a sound when it pops, but at least it won't distract you with anything else. Buff bar is important and we want to keep it under our first area of attention, but slightly to the left because debuff bar is actually more important. We also want to make it a little bigger. Chat window is a hard topic for many reasons. For me personally, I don't care about chat that much. If you're getting a whisper from your friend, you will be able to read it after the match. If you're getting harassed, I immediately use mute button. I personally put it into this bottom right corner and make it barely readable for it not to distract me. I still keep it for high rank games since a lot of experienced players will mark when they got enemy relics on the cooldown, and is the only mechanic that allows you to know that information. But if you feel that you are easily tilted in general and want to improve on that, or just having a bad day and don't want to engage in general toxicity of Smite community, just want to really try hard and focus on your game, you may as well make that chat small as possible, or even hide it on top of the other element to make it completely unreadable, thus basically non-existent. Debuff bar, extremely important during fights. More important than buffs, since reacting to aggression is more important, thus you want to put it under your first area of attention, which is right under your god, and also make it a little bit bigger according to a screen resolution. Enemy deaths is the element that leaves icons of the enemies that have just died after the kill message have disappeared, and is completely rudimentary since there are two other elements that provide this information. Kill message that is temporary, and enemy display that is permanent, and should be checked anyway for you to understand how much time you have until that enemy responds and what is your next action might be. Enemy display is an important element that will provide you with the information about the number of enemies that are alive and the time that they will remain dead. I will place it on top here because I personally plan my relics at the start of the game while in the shop and like to see the enemy composition during that time. If you're using tap screen for that, you might like to place it somewhere else. Free mouse help is the rudimentary useless element that is here to prove that the HUD editor itself is a very poorly written buggy tool that is mostly forgotten because it somewhat serves the purpose and haven't been looked at for more than 5 years and 2 UI overhauls. It is literally there to remind you of what button to press to use free mouse and is even disabled by default. Friendly deaths is the element, as previously mentioned, enemy deaths, and for the same reason should be disabled. Health bar is a small icon on top of your character with your health and mana. It should be disabled since that information is already duplicated on the screen in a much more informative way, and also because at most screen resolutions, it is heavily blocking your point of vision. It is actually disabled through your settings, and I strongly recommend to do that because it is a disgrace to all of UI design. Item display is the redundant old element from times of Smite beta that was showing the items you built and has no right to exist anymore, thus it is even disabled by default. The only people you might see using that one are all the Smite players such as myself that play this game since beta. Think pro players like Adapin or Barracuda since they are too used to the old design. But I personally switched the first patch they implemented the new element where stats and items are combined since it decreases the number of points you need to pay attention to. I strongly recommend to keep it turned off and forget it exists. Kill message is one of the key pieces of information. Right now it is one of the most vision blocking elements popping right on top of your center of attention. You want to make it pretty big and place it right on top of your score panel, because when it actually pops up it will not block any information on the score display. Level up is a useless element that is literally a word popping up in the center of your attention area and is literally a word level up. This information is extremely redundant, since it's duplicated in three elements that you are actually actively using, as well as giving you a visual and sound effect when you level up. Make it disappear and forget it exists. Minimap, the most important element on the screen for the reasoning that we already mentioned. I place it right in the middle of my second attention area, which is right next to my god and my first attention area, which is an actual game. This allows me to switch attention back and forth with another area always in my peripheral vision at all times, surrounded by other key elements in the peripheral vision of that area. Make it a little more transparent by increasing the opacity to be able to distinct the elements of terrain, but still see through it, and make it of appropriate size. There are two possible sizes for that element. You generally want to make it small to be able to grasp all of the information at once, but if you make it a little bit bigger, at certain points the icon on the map will get much bigger, thus easier to spot. The downside of that is that if two enemies or allies are right next to each other on the map, it will be much harder to see that there are actually two enemies. Which sizes you use is a matter of preference. I personally prefer smaller icons as of late, even though in the past I always use bigger ones. Notification is the element that tells you about servers going down and that kind of stuff. Extremely rare and completely unimportant element in my opinion that also pops up right in the middle of the screen. I personally get rid of it. Objective health is a crucial element that you want to use during Gold Fury, Pyromancer, Fire Giant fights, and Tower Sieges. Currently, not only it is placed on top of your screen, where if you want to look at it, your key attention areas will be barely in your peripheral vision, but it also blocks the in-game numbered pop-ups of the actual damage you do to objectives in melee range. So place it around your first attention area, since objective fights are usually a dynamic environment where you would mostly try to control your god most of all. Objectives are a useless element for conquest. It is used for points representation in arena and siege mods. If you don't ever play those mods, feel free to disable that element entirely. Or you can just put it in our garbage corner without disabling it for a few rare occasions where you might want to fool around in those mods or match of the day with your friends. Passive meter. Its importance strongly varies from absolutely crucial to completely irrelevant depending on the god you play. I usually put it next to my buff bars, but if you main a lot of Uller or Hell or Kronos, you might want to think of a better, more easily available place for it. When I was maining Kronos myself, I caught myself a lot of times looking at the passive meter in a not convenient place and getting caught off guard a lot because of that. Player bar is the second most important UI element on your screen after the minimap. A lot of people tend to make it as small as possible because it's ugly, it blows the significant portion of your bottom screen, but in my opinion, what you actually should do is make it as big as possible. Reasoning behind it is quite simple. There should be no situation during teamfights where you should need to actually look at that bar specifically to get any information it provides. Your health and mana should be available at a glance near it, and your skill and relics are available when their icons are completely lit up. However, there exists a quite significant problem with cooldown's representation in this element that I'm unsuccessfully ranting to fix for around 6 years now. Since the icon lights up a portion of the icon during cooldown, representing a clock, the skill you want to use is near its cooldown but not quite there yet in your peripheral vision, you will most probably see it as available, thus usually putting you into a stupid situation where you are trying to use something you don't yet have access to instead of disengaging or juking. This problem is especially noticeable with relics since their cooldowns are much longer and you may see almost fully lit up icons for a great portion of the time. This is easily fixable by making the icon a bit grayed out before the respawn actually finishes, but it is something that haven't been fixed for 6 years now. The best way to reduce that problem is to make the player bar element as big as your resolution allows you to. Score display. Same idea, it is located on top of your screen where it doesn't actually block any of your vision. Make it significantly bigger, align other elements around it and keep it that way. It is ugly, but we're discussing effectiveness here and it's a lot easier to grasp information from bigger elements than try to make it out from small ones. Stat display follows the same idea. You cannot move it from its location, it is not required often, but when you want to get information, you want to do that as fast as possible. And bigger element will give you that information faster. It is also used to some extent as a skill bar with your peripheral vision in case you play gods that rely on items that can be activated like Polynomicon, Warrior Blessing or Shield of Regrowth. Surrender. Right now it pops up in left middle of your screen and is pretty big. This is a situational, almost non-important element that you want to hide as much as you can but still keep it accessible for obvious reasons. You can also make it smaller. Team display is a little bit tricky in my opinion, since it was upgraded at some point to a more easily distinguished vertical version that is also bigger and more convenient, but since this haven't been done to an enemy display, you actually want to change it back to its old form and make it as big as possible just like enemy display. Setting it under the enemy display because of the ultimate cooldowns diamonds. This positioning of those elements will allow you to access the health, mana and ultimate availability of your teammates during teamfights at a glance, while also comparing how many players are dead on each team. Upgrade display is a redundant element that literally shows you what kind of items you just purchased through the shop or what kind of skills you just leveled up with a huge distracting pop-up icon of that skill or item on the screen with a very loud and obnoxious sound to boot. Unfortunately, you cannot disable the sound, but you want to disable this element unless your brain does not know what your hands are doing. VGS menu is a visual representation of your VGS patterns. If you are extremely versatile with your VGS and know every single command, you might actually want to disable it entirely. But personally, I use VGS very aggressively during my games, since your region doesn't really use voice comms as much, and sometimes you just can't remember the combination that you need for some reason. Without taking a quick peek at the menu, I tend to make this element pretty small but still readable and get it out of my field of vision right in top left corner here. This element also has a habit of disappearing from the HUD editor entirely, thus preventing you from any manipulations with it. And usually this issue will persist until you restart the game. Since we are already on the topic of the HUD, here are also some things that I am also always changing in my settings that are related to visual representation of your in-game HUD. User interface tab in the settings. Here you want to disable it, show your health as we already mentioned before. You should also change your nameplates to none since that will lighten the bloat on the screen from your enemy and teammates health bars. Friend online notification or never or lobby. Never on always or in game. Show help tips should be disabled unless you play this game for your first few weeks. Block chat messages from non-friends might also be a great idea if you feel like you might be of an easily tiltable kind. Show mana usage should be enabled and combat text scaling cranked up to the maximum since you want to see those numbers as best as you can. Controls tab. Here you want to disable mouse smoothing to gain more precision on your mouse movement. Restricted camera pitch, however, is up to debate. A lot of people use it because it provides a little bit more vision, but for me personally it takes away from your precision, since after a certain amount of camera tilt, your cursor actually leaves the center of the map, which is a big hit to your muscle memory and your ability to aim closer or farther away from your characters in any game, not only Smite. You can see that a lot of top or even pro players actually use restricted camera pitch, yet you might also notice those same players actually using the default HUD layout. And since restricted camera pitch is turned on by default, this might actually be the reason why. Majority of oldest players would disable it since this feature was not present in the early stages of Smite development. Targeting tab. Distance lies should be either just line or none. There's no real reason to use ruler, since the range display is also wrong. Ground targeter is arrow, since it uses the high contrast element, but it's even bigger, which is crucial if you are using Instacast, which is what you should be using unless you're playing Smite for your first couple weeks or haven't played that specific god just yet. Reticule is a redundant element that you should not be using since its function is duplicated by the ruler and the ground targeter and serves literally no purpose apart from bloating your screen. And that will be all for the settings menu of HUD editing. And this will conclude the guide. This is the best idea of top performance and effectiveness of your in-game Smite HUD, and hopefully this guide was helpful for you. And if you enjoyed the video, as always, like, comment and subscribe. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next video.